I already explained about mechanism of respiration. So how the whole process will take place? Breathe out and breathe in process will controlled by a flattened muscular like structure that is called diaphragm. This diaphragm only can regulate the flow of air and breathe in and breathe out process. Understood, children? What is the nature of the lungs? Lungs are elastic and sponge in nature. They have the ability to move upward and downward direction, but they cannot able to move itself with the help of diaphragm. When the diaphragm can regulate, when it is able to contract or relax, then only we can see the two processes, the inspiration and expiration. I already explained in previous lesson. What I explained? When these diaphragm can contract, then that shape of the diaphragm become flattened and the chest cavity, the area of the chest cavity can increase. So due to the increase of this chest cavity, there is no internal pressure. So there is no internal pressure in the sense the lungs have the capability to rush out the, they want to absorb oxygen. When you have to breathe, there is a space to enter the air. Understood, children? This process we call as inhale or inspiration. Understood, children? And the next one is when the diaphragm can relax, then what did you understand? It become dome shape in structure and the area of the chest cavity can decrease. So due to the decrease of this volume of the chest cavity, there is a pressure, internal pressure in the lungs. So they want to squeeze and push out the air from their lungs. That is the main function of the diaphragm. In previous class I already explained it. So we already know the pathway of respiration. So the respiration can start from nasal nostrils to blood. So when the blood can be purified, where do we have to observe the purification? That is when it can mix with the oxygen, when the exchange of gases will take place in alveoli. So where is we can observe the alveoli? Bronchioles, say no. Three, in case of right lung, we can see that. What we can see? Three lobe structures are there. Those are called bronchioles. At the end of the bronchioles, clusters of eight sacs are connected to this end of the bronchioles. These clusters we call as eight sacs. These eight sacs we call as alveoli. What is that? Alveoli. In this alveoli only we can see the exchange of gases. What are the gases can exchange? Oxygen can send into the blood capillaries, and these blood capillaries are connected to the arteries and veins. These are the blood vessels. Three different types of blood vessels are helped to pump the blood through the heart. What are those? Arteries, veins, and then blood capillaries. lungs only. Due to this compression of alveoli in these lungs to increase the moist surface. And where we can see, and they have the ability to exchange the gases between both blood and what is that? Alveoli. What is the process is going on here? Exchange of gases will take place and where between the blood and then alveoli. Thus, alveoli only plays a major role to exchange the gases. Now, I'll explain about exchange of gases. Okay, children, now we are going to see that this is the structure of the alveoli. I already said that clusters of 8 sacs. These clusters of 8 sacs are called as alveoli. So this is alveoli. Understood, children? So here only we can see the exchange of gases. And a branch-like structure is there. This is a bronchioles. These bronchioles are connected to this 8 sac, that is alveoli. When the air can enter into the nostrils, then the nostrils can send the air through the nasal cavity and then to the next part, that is the junction between both the digestive tract and the respiratory tract, that is called pharynx. And it has a flap-like muscular valve, that is called epiglottis. This epiglottis only can regulate the movement of air and food to their respective passages. So here, the nervous system plays a major role to regulate the epiglottis. How? When these nerves can reach, when the air can enter, when the air can touch the epiglottis, automatically the nerves can send the information to the epiglottis. Then the wall of this epiglottis can open completely. Then the air can enter into the next part of the respiratory system, that is called larynx. Understood, children? If the food substances can enter, then what happens? The food particles can enter into the pharynx. Then what happened there? These nerves can send the information to the epiglottis. Solid particles are ready to enter. Then this epiglottis cannot open completely. Partly, a little bit can open. That's it. If it can open completely, what happened? These food particles cannot enter into the esophagus and they can enter into the windpipe, that is the trachea. So it leads to choking. Understood, children? To avoid the problem, these epiglottis control the flow of air and food. Understood, children? Then larynx, we already know that larynx have 9 vocal cords. When the air can enter, these vocal cords can vibrate. Then what happened? We are able to speak. The sound can produce when the vocal cords can vibrate. Understood, children? And the next, the air can enter into the trachea. A C-shaped curve-like structures are there. And at the lower portion of the trachea are connected to this channel-like structure. Those are called bronchi. And these bronchi, they're having, the right lung has 3 lobes and the left lung has 2 lobes. That is due to the presence of heart near to the left lung. Understood, children? Then the air can enter into the bronchioles. These bronchioles, at the end of the bronchioles, we can see a clusters of 8 sacs. These clusters of 8 sacs are called as alveoli. Here only we can see the exchange of gases. When the air can enter, then what happened? The carbon dioxide, already these are connected to the blood capillaries there, no? Small hair-like structures. What are the blood capillaries? These are small hair-like structures. These are connected to the both arteries and veins, and one side is connected to the tissues of the muscles, that is the body. Understood, children? So these blood capillaries will collect the carbon dioxide from the tissues and it can send to the alveoli. And when the oxygen get mixed with the blood, then what happened? The blood become dark red in color. That is, when the blood is combined with oxygen to form oxyhemoglobin. Understood, children? So, this oxygen can enter into the blood capillaries. And these blood capillaries are connected to arteries and veins. Understood? Clear or not? So, arteries plays a major role to collect the blood from the heart, and arteries can supply oxygenated blood to different parts of our body. Understood, children? Exchange of gases will take place in this alveoli. How? These blood capillaries collect the carbon dioxide from different parts of the tissues. Understood? And that can be sent to the carbon dioxide. And the carbon dioxide can send to the alveoli. And this alveoli can send the carbon dioxide to the bronchioles. Then the bronchioles can send to the bronchi. Then it can send to the windpipe, that is trachea and larynx. And it can go to the pharynx and then nasal cavity. And through the nostrils, we can see a large amount of carbon dioxide will come out during the process of exhale. So we are rid of carbon dioxide. After exhaling the gases, we can see the rid of carbon dioxide from our body. Understood, children? We are free from carbon dioxide. Again, the oxygen can enter through the capillaries, and these blood capillaries can connect to the different tissues of the body, and each and every tissue can receive the oxygen. Then cellular respiration will take place. Understood, children? This is about the exchange of gases by the process of diffusion. Do you know what is the process is going on here? What is the process? Diffusion. Diffusion in the sense, the substances can pass from high concentration to the low concentration, or the substances can pass through any media, either by water or by wind. So here, what is the media here? In case of alveoli, already the lungs are filled with air. Air in the sense wind only. So wind is the media to transport the substances. What are those? Here, this oxygen can transport through the blood capillaries by the process of diffusion. And again, the carbon dioxide will come out through the body, through the lungs, over the body. It's called diffusion. Understood, children? Simply, what is the process is going on there during the process of exchange of gases? What is that? The process we call as diffusion. Diffusion in the sense, the substances can pass from high concentration to the low concentration. That is one definition. Or the substances can spread either by any media, either by water or by wind. Here, the lungs are filled with air. So, air is a media for this diffusion process in exchange of gases. Understood, children? This is about exchange of gases. So during this process, both exhale and inhale processes will take place now. So now let's go and see what is the percentage of gases when we inhale. I will explain later during the time of exhale. What are the gases can release in how much percent? I'll explain one by one. Understood, children? Now, the same amount of nitrogen during the process of exhale also, that is 78%. Can release out. There is no use of nitrogen in our body. Understood, children? And the next one is oxygen. During the process of inhale, 68% of oxygen can release. Understood, children? How much amount of oxygen we can breathe out? That is 68% of oxygen we can breathe out. And then here, carbon dioxide. How much percent of carbon dioxide we can inhale? That is 0.03. But during exhale process, how much amount of carbon dioxide can exhale? That is 4.4% of carbon dioxide can exhale. But here we breathe only a little amount. But we can breathe out a large amount of carbon dioxide. That carbon dioxide will be collected by blood capillaries from different parts of the tissues. Understood, children? Clear or not? Here, the remaining carbon dioxide will come out from the different parts of the tissues by Heilig structures. Those are called blood capillaries. These blood capillaries only can collect the carbon dioxide from different parts of the tissues. So here, 4.4% of carbon dioxide can be released during the process of exhale. Understood, children? Clear or not? So these are the different percentage. During the time of inhale, we can breathe only 78% of nitrogen. The whole percentage of nitrogen can exhale out. And the oxygen is 21%. But during the process of exhale, we can release 16%. But the remaining percentage, they know that remaining percentage of oxygen can again send through the blood capillaries to all parts of the tissues. Then only the cellular respiration will take place. So here, which gas is able to circulate in our body? That is oxygen. Understood, children? So the lung capacity of A is 5,800 liters. Understood, children? But when you are in rest, either by exhale or by inhale process, you can release at least 500 liters of gas, and the remaining gas, 1200 liters of gas will be there that can be exhaled. Understood, children? This is about the gases, exchange of gases in alveoli. Alveoli only plays a major role to exchange the gases by the process of diffusion. Thank you, children.